as a newcomer, you realize that you have the privilege to be there in the right place at the right time. And if you would been born, I don't know, 10 years later or 10 years earlier, you might have not been able to contribute in the same way.
Here at CERN, scientists have been searching for the Higgs deep under the Swiss-French border, using the most powerful particle accelerator ever built.
The temperature that is in these collisions is such that you go back to a fraction of a second after the Big Bang. So things that could happen a fraction of a second after the Big Bang happen again.
Shortly after the Big Bang, when the universe was created, the Higgs boson came into being and gave all the other particles substance, which is why some refer to it as the God particle.
This is the stumbling block. We need to know if this particle exists or not.
We started getting this bigger picture coming into place. It really looked okay. There is something at this particular mass, and it's very significant.
In the past few minutes, scientists here have reported that one of the LHC's experiments have found a faint signal of the Higgs.
You start doubting yourself. Are we sure that we checked everything? Are we sure we don't have correlations or that we did not miscalibrate the detector?
But what's causing huge excitement here is that people are saying that another experiment at the LHC, using different methods, has also found the blip in the same place.
And that's where what I really wanted to see was the result of the other experiment. I mean, did they see something like us? To it is, we were running so fast and we were so focused in delivering something. It really was in the morning of the seminar that I saw this huge queue going around the main building here at CERN. So that's when I started realizing the importance.
Today is also a special day because we hear two presentations on their update on a search for a certain particle.
Conclude by saying that we have observed a new boson.
Clinically, except one big spike here in this region.
The moment when I saw the results of the other experiment, that I realized, okay, they see the same thing. Wow.
Scientists in Switzerland say they think they've discovered the particle which gives everything in the universe its size and shape.
And full of emotion at the news, the British scientist who predicted the particle's existence.
For me, it's really an incredible thing that it's happened in my lifetime.
I've never heard such a loud clap as I've heard then. It was really thunderous.
This day will go down as one of the great days in the history of science, I think.
We now have this new tool and we can learn more about what nature is and how the universe works by using this tool.